Hi there, my name is Darren Watson and I'm a blues guitarist from Wellington, New Zealand. I want to take you through today one of my favourite guitar players when it comes to playing behind harmonica, and that is a cat called Robert Lockwood, or Robert Junior Lockwood, or Robert Lockwood Junior. Really amazing guitar player. There's one tune he did while backing Little Walter called Shake Dancer, which can almost be like a primer or a primer, whichever one you're supposed to say it, for playing blues guitar behind harmonica. It's got so many ideas. So what I'll do first is I'll just take you through the whole thing, and then I'll kind of dissect it a little for you so you can see what's going on. So this is just kind of playing along to the original recording, really. So see that there's a whole lot of stuff going on here. He's not just kind of... Not that there's anything wrong with that for some stuff, but just this lighter swinging feel, that's Freddie Below on the drums, or B-Low, or Below, or whatever. Look out below, because the guy's a motherfucker. A scary, scary drummer. Real swinger, man. He's just amazing. He played with a lot of people in that time. Anyway. So yeah, you could just kind of boogie away like this. What Lockwood did was kind of take little horn lines or things a piano player might play and chuck them in. So while the bass is doing this kind of repetitive one, what is it, a 1-5 dominant 7-1 kind of line, like one. And that's pretty much the whole thing. He's kind of playing these 9 chords at the start, so it's really easy. It's 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4. So that's just kind of taking the bottom 3 strings of a 9 chord up here on the 7th fret E9 and sliding it up to like an F sharp 9 position, sliding it back down. Then he goes up to A9, does the same thing, then back again. My favorite favourite thing that he does here is he breaks up a B, a normal B chord up here at the 7th. So he just breaks it up and plays the G string. Okay? So all he's doing is playing those two notes, but he's doing this little jump thing. One and a two and a three and a, and listen to where he changes. He goes down by semitones down to the A. One and a two and a three and a. One and a two and a three and a four and a. So he just plays and a in B flat. So one and a two and a three and a four and a. So one and a two and a three and a four and a two and a three. Okay, 3rd fret B string, open B string, open G, second fret G, down to 1st fret, that's the G sharp note, so. Then the coolest little lick, which is just 3, little hammer off on 2, so 3, 2, then you do the same thing on the B string. A C9 playing C9. Okay, but we're going to play a G on the bottom here. Down to a B9 with an F sharp on the bottom. So that. But that's about the only thing that he does throughout the whole song is the same. Next 12 bars. He jumps on this kind of like da 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 da, like what a piano player would play, just playing triplets. E7 chord here, and just. I'm pretty sure he played with finger picks, so he's probably kind of going. If you want to play it with a flat pick, I kind of tend to think downstroke sound about right. And then up to an E9 chord for the last bar. Okay, so you got one and a two and a three and a four and a two and a two and a three and a four and a three and a two and a three and a four and a four and a two and a three and a. Okay, then we go to A and we're going to play. Okay, so it's just taking the B and G string of that kind of A chord, and then just imagine you're playing a D, but you're only doing this really. So you. So you start here on the A note on the D string, then you play the rest of the D chord, then go down to A, and back up to D. Then he goes back to, just like you did, in the first 12, yeah? Then, there's a whole lot more to it than that, but hopefully this is a kind of a way for you to think outside of just. It's easy, you know. Bunch of this kind of stuff, and it really does improve your kind of getting stuck in this kind of rut of always just playing this kind of thing, you know, which is cool. It's a great thing, but Robert Lockwood used to call it the bomba bomba shit, and I think he was right in a lot of ways. There's so many other ways you can kind of approach playing this stuff. Especially with nine chords, man, they just sound great. And just that little slide thing. Okay, one more thing. That one chord that you'll notice that I am using, that kind of extended ninth. How can I not talk about this chord, man? Okay, so there's a regular E9. So you got, starting from the A string, heading down, you've got 11, 12, 11, 12, 12. Right, so here's the extended version. This is basically putting this fantastic note that you can really hear it, especially the way that it's spread out on this chord, man, because it's, you know, when you put a G sharp there and a higher E on top of it, it's a massive sound. So you're going 12 from the D string, you're going 12, 11, 9, 12. 12, 11, 9, 12. Just such a... I think Stevie Ray Vaughan probably uses that one a fair bit, or did, obviously. Anyway, hopefully that's a little insight into some of Robert Lockwood's great playing. He could play in a bunch of other styles too, but the swinging stuff that he did, the rhythm playing, is almost without peer. So go and check him out. He plays with a bunch of guys, with Sonny Boy Williamson, number two, Little Walter. He's done a bunch of records on his own. In fact, I believe he only passed away very recently. So, yeah, go check him out. Anyway, thanks for listening. My name is Darren Watson, and hopefully this has been a help to you. Cheers.